So this is my 1.6 HDI engine oil catch can update. This is just one of many. So the first update, I've traveled roughly about 500-600 miles, roughly about a month and a half. So I really wanted to check the pipes and see if they really does it collect what it collects. So I'll empty it in a second. Then I'll check the pipes to see if any oil travels up. So if oil travels up, so it means that this doesn't really do its job. So first collection of the fluid has been collected. So really, let me push the jar first. I've hidden it quite inside here. That's the hose. I mean that's the hose inside. So I've hidden it. There was a hole here in this plastic, so I've kind of hidden it so it doesn't really dangle. And with a clip. That's my hose. So this is the jar. So this is really my kind of safe bit with a. A bit of a hose inside, so just if this fails, so it will stop. So now we have to actually drain it. Let's see, well, I know it's quite a bit of water inside, but I can't be seen the way I'm doing it. Almost nothing. So it's a bit of a yellowish fluid, mostly water, but I've been driving in a lot of humid weather. There's been recently quite a bit of rain, so it's mainly condensation, but we'll probably start now. We'll start collecting more as the weather becomes more hot. It will collect more as a proportion, more oil than just whatever blow by gases, some fuel, perhaps a bit of oil diluted, but not really that much. I mean, so this is really what it's collected. It's fairly watery, it's not that much. It's kind of a yellowish, watery. Maybe there is a very small percentage of water. I mean, it's very little because my hose is roughly about, I think, 13 mil. So if I calculate the circumference, and the volume is roughly about 60 milliliters of fluid I can collect in my hose, so I'll probably have to fit a fatter hose from the old catch can down, so it will collect more. I mean, he hasn't really collected much oil, pretty much condensation. So I've slackened the tubes to see what's the condition. And so the first thing, so I already did that. So just a quick from this the breather. I mean, you cannot quite see it there. I suspect you can, but if I put my finger in there, it really there is quite a bit of oil. Yeah, you can see there is a bit of oil. So in other words, oil vapors travel from the oil catch can up, so the catch can doesn't really condense the oil vapor. So I've put my finger up there. Yeah, there is. My finger becomes slightly on the darker side, so it does let quite a few oily bits and pieces. So from here, I mean, this is pretty clean. Let me shine the torch. That is pretty clean. There are a few specks of oil that have come up. But nothing really has traveled back. Alright. So, my flashlight. Yeah, not really that much. So there is nothing in between here where it, the failsafe valve hasn't opened. So if there is stuff in between here, between this edge, so it means that the failsafe valve has opened. So if there's nothing here, so it means that it's been all right. And inside, I mean, you can see some stuff around here that are fairly darkish. Let me have a close-up look. So, it has a few bits and pieces that have drips, but it's not really that much. That's how it looks inside. And opening it. So these are their bits and pieces. I mean, it's fairly, looks fairly okay-ish. Inside there is not really much to see. I mean, this is not only kind of, but you can see there is a bit of a oily bit. There is some water, but it's fairly fairly oily. So oil does come around this end. So first you look at the outlet pipe. It's not. Yep, he fell down. Catch it up later. I mean, not much really can be seen. I can't really shine anymore. I mean, there is an oil here at the beginning, but it probably cools down towards here. Yeah, there is on the copper, on the difference, probably in temperature, yeah, there is a bit of oil, so oil travels up and cools down and collects. So, yeah, you can see it here and there. I mean, it doesn't do a, the oil catch can doesn't do a perfect role. So next thing is to undo that pipe, but I suspect there will be a bit of oil inside, so I'll put the jar there to tip it over. Once I open this up, which is fairly difficult. Well, it's not too bad. I've positioned this so if there is anything. Yeah, there is a bit of a darkish, so let's see if anything drops. No, not really, but my finger is quite oily, so there is oil coming up here. I mean, yeah, you can see. And also here, yeah, my finger is also oily, so oil comes up, and this is pretty thickish oil. It's not really, well, it's pretty, well, it's very thick. So oil comes out, form of vapor travels. See, not much can be actually seen. So all vapor really travels, but the vapor doesn't really condense very much in the oil catch can. So somebody on YouTube, on my channel, already commented that this element, I try to wipe it, well, oil comes down here, but it doesn't really. So somebody commented that this, somebody commented, well, there is, I just wiped it, and there is a bit of a oil here and there. So somebody commented that because this is steel, it doesn't filter that well, it doesn't have that many layers, so These are two layers of mesh, and it's supposed to be steel scourers in between. So it probably, I agree, it's cheap and it doesn't work as well as the original one. But what we decided to do is stuff this inside with steel scourers, not steel wool, but steel scourers. Stick this inside and see if this can act as a better filter and start collecting oil rather than pushing it up the pipes. And if that doesn't work, then I'll probably have to buy the original one. So next is to stuff this. So I'll put probably two of these, just not to create too much of a blockage. Hopefully the steel filter around will stop if any bits fall, but this shouldn't really break, it's steel. So I'll put two to see how it goes. I mean, not great too much blockage, but we'll see. Yeah, I don't like this, but that will be probably alright. Hopefully it won't create too much block. We'll see if it collects. Yeah, that should be alright. Let's see if this filters through and starts collecting oil. Well, that's let's move this on. I mean, this is it for the moment. So I put the steel scourers to see how this will go around, whether it will start collecting oil and not coming up, and hopefully this will create a nice filter. If this doesn't work, I'll have to buy the original one. So I'll put everything back together, and in out of 500-600 miles, I'll report again if that actually works. So thank you very much for watching this update. Subscribe for more updates, and hopefully that's useful. Thank you very much.